Hi guys, welcome to Learning Lad, and in this video we will see how we can write a simple C program to display its own source code as the output. So to display the contents of a file, first we need to know where exactly that file is located, or in other words, we need to know the path and the file name. So how we can get the file name along with the path of the source file which has been executing. In C programming, if you have learned about the preprocessors, then there is a predefined macro available and it is called as file, and this predefined macro file expands to the name of the current input file in the form of a C string, and this will be the file name along with the path of the file which the preprocessor has opened for preprocessing. So we know that before the compilation process there is this preprocessing, and during the preprocessing the predefined macros will be expanded, and this file predefined macro will contain the file name along with the path which has been opened. So we can use this file predefined macro and we can get the file name along with the path of the file which has been executing. So now we know how we can get the file name and the path. The next thing that we have to do is we just have to print out the contents of that file, which will be easy. So here, just to show you guys the contents of this file predefined macro, I'm gonna use a printf function. Here we know that it will be in the form of a string, so I'm gonna use the %s format specifier, or you know, I can say here like file is %s, and that predefined macro is underscore underscore file underscore underscore. All right, now I'm gonna save this program and I'm gonna build and run this, and now you guys can see file is D YouTube Hindi C source codes sc program main.c. I have saved this project in this sc program folder, which is inside this C source codes, which is inside this YouTube Hindi, which is inside my D drive, and the file name is main.c. So now we have access to the file name along with the path. The next thing that we have to do is we have to print out the contents of this file. So let's write a program for that. Here, since we are working with the files, we need a file pointer. So it's gonna be file, and I'm gonna call it as fp for file pointer. And then what we are going to do is we are going to read the content of the file character by character. So to store that read character, we need a character variable. I'm gonna call it as C or CH. And then I'm gonna open up the file. So we will use the fopen function. So here, as a first parameter, we need to give the file name along with the path that we want to open, and it should be a string value. So, and here we know that we have this macro file, which provides the file name along with the path in the form of a string value. And then in which mode we want to open the file, we want to open it for reading, so the mode will be R, and then the fopen function will return a pointer to that file. So we will store that pointer in this fp variable that we have created, fp pointer that we have created. And then here what we can do is we can check whether the file has been opened properly or not. So we can do that by using a if statement. If fp equal to null, then it will mean that there was some problem while opening the file. So I'm gonna use the printf function, and I'm gonna say error opening the file, else it means that we were successful while opening the file. So now what we can do is we can print out the content of that file. So I'm gonna use a do while loop. So it will be do, and then we read the content of the file character by character. So for that we will use the getc function, and here we need to specify the file from which we are reading. So I'll specify fp here, and this getc function will return the character it has read from the file, and we will store that in our ch variable. So now we have read one character from this file. So what we can do is we can print out that file. So it's gonna be %c because we are printing a character, and the character will be in this ch variable. All right, now we have the condition here in while. So it is a do while loop, and the condition is we want to read the contents of this file until we reach the end of the file. So how we know that we have reached the end of the file? When we have read all the contents of this file, the last character read from the file will be end of the file character. So we will check for that. If the character read is not equal to end of the file character EOF, then we want to continue this loop. So when this character read from this file is an end of the file character, and then it will mean that we have read all the contents of the file. So now after reading the contents from this file, what we do is we close this file. So to close the file, we use the function fclose, and here we need to specify the file pointer. Okay, now if I build and run this program, I have an error, and that's because I forgot to add the semicolon here. So let me quickly add that. Okay, now I'm gonna build and run this again, and this time you guys can see the program has run and it has displayed this program as the output. So you guys can see here the same program which we have written in this editor is the output of this program. So the next thing that I'm gonna do here is I want to show you guys the output of the preprocessor. So let's quickly open up the folder where we have saved this program. Now you know that we have this program saved in this main.c file, which is inside SC program folder, which is inside C source codes, which is inside YouTube Hindi, which is inside my D drive. So now first what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up the command prompt in this location, or here I'm opening the command prompt in the location where I have saved my program. So to open up the command prompt here, I just need to come to this URL section, click on that, and then I need to write cmd and hit the enter button. Now we have opened up the command prompt in this location that I have specified. Now here I can use the gcc command and I can run this program, and here we want to display the output of the preprocessor, and that's why I need to use -e here option with this gcc, which will display only the output of the preprocessor. And since we are in the folder where we have stored our program, to access this file we just need to give the file name. So here it's gonna be main.c, and if I hit the enter button, it will display all the contents of the preprocessor's output. If you want, you can redirect this output to a file and save it, but I'm not gonna do that here. Now if you look at the source code here, we have used this file macro while opening this file. So if I come back to this line, then you guys can see fp equal to fopen main.c, and you know, this file macro has been expanded to this file name, and it has given only the file name here. That's because we were in the same folder where this main.c was stored, and we were executing this program, or you know, we were calling this command from that folder, and that's why we just passed main.c, and that's why this file macro will contain only this file name, which is main.c. But if we were executing this program from some other folder, then what happens? So let me quickly copy this location, and let me quickly go to my desktop. Okay, now here I'm in the desktop, and now if I want to run this program, which is inside my D drive, YouTube Hindi folder, and some other folders, then I just can't type in gcc minus e and you know that main.c. It will not work because the main.c is not present in the desktop, it is in some other folder. Now if I try to run this, it will generate the error. So now this time I need to provide gcc minus e for preprocessor's output only, and then I need to specify the path. So here I'm gonna specify the path in a double quote. That's because I have spaces in my folder names. You guys can see I have these spaces in my path: D YouTube Hindi, C source codes, and then SC program, and then we have main.c, which is the file name. So this is the path I have to give in this case. And now if I hit the enter button, it will, you know, show you the preprocessor's output. And now if you come back to this location, if you look at this line, fp equal to fopen, and this file macro has been expanded to this path that we have given. So the main.c source code is present in this path, and right now it will expand to this path only. Let me quickly expand it so that you guys can see it in one line. Now you guys can see here. I just wanted to show this one. So this is it, guys, for this video. Now if you like this video, then hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to watch more tutorials, then do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later in the next video.